Resource allocation graph. Now, here is what we can see about the deadlock, whether it is there is a deadlock or not. For that, deadlocks can be described in terms of we have a resource allocation graph. Now, in this resource allocation graph, it consists of certain parts because we know that graph consists of vertices and edges. A graph consists of vertices and edges. So, vertices are partitioned into two types. First is your process and then you have resource. So, process can be number of processes, P1 to Pn. These are all set consisting of all the processes in the system. We have R, which is the set consisting of all the resource types in the system. Then we have a request edge. Request edge is directed edge from P1 to Rj. That means this process is requesting for this resource. Assignment edge, Rj to Pi, this is again a directed edge that means you have a direction. This means the resource R or this is R is assigned to Pi. That is some process is holding that resource, that is assignment edge. The process can be represented like this with a bubble or a circle. Resource of multiple instances like this resource, one resource is of four instances is there. So, four resources of similar type are there. Now, when P request instance of Rj, we represent it like this. And when Pi or process is holding an instance of R, we do it like this. So, this is an example of a resource allocation graph. If you see that P1 or let us start with P2. P2 is holding R1. P3 is holding R3. P1 is expecting R1 and this P1 is holding R2. P2 is again asking for R3. It is holding R1. So, if a resource allocation graph that it has no cycle, then the system cannot be in a deadlock state. But if there is a cycle, that means this kind of cycle. If you can see, is there any cycle? See, this, no, there is no cycle. If there is a cycle, then the system may or may not be in a deadlock state. Resource allocation graph with deadlock. Let us see an example of that. See, in this, we have P2 wanting R3, but R3 is assigned to P3. And P3 is wanting R2. And R2 is assigned to P2. So, this is a circle. This is a circle or this is a cycle. Now, when a cycle is there, that means the system may be in deadlock, may not be in deadlock. But we have conditions also where there are certain situations where we have a cycle, but there is no deadlock. See, if you observe it very closely, P1 is, because there are multiple instances. So, P1 is expecting R1. R1 is held by P3. P3 is expecting or wanting R2. But R2 is held by P1. But the system is not in deadlock because we have more than one instances of R, that is the resources. So, the basic facts about this RAG resource allocation graph is if a graph contains no cycle, that means no deadlock. But if a graph does contain a cycle, if we have single instance of that resource, then the deadlock would be there. If we have multiple instances of resource type, possibility of deadlock is there. We cannot say here the deadlock is there or not.